All right, I want to talk about the American Dream. Yeah. Well, in Jersey, it means different things. The American Dream in Jersey means what I'm calling a total boondoggle at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, where developer 555 is looking at developing, redeveloping the 91-acre site. If you know, you see it when you come down the turnpike. It's one of the ugliest things in New Jersey. Like, I think what they did was they tried to match the paint to look like the Port Elizabeth with all the containers. Because, you know, the people always say, man, those containers are beautiful. Can we just duplicate that? Like, we should start painting our houses that way in New Jersey. Anyway, and the big thing that's sticking up in the sky, that's allegedly going to be an indoor ski resort. Here's the problem. According to some, this is going to cost you plenty. Just as a taxpayer, not even when you go to use the services, if you go, which I'm betting you won't. So I'm checking in with State Senator Mike Doherty, who has been an outspoken critic of what looks like could be a real, real problem for taxpayers. Senator, good morning and welcome back to New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, Bill. Very good to be with you.
So, Mike, let me ask you, what is the problem with this? I mean, I've talked about this for a while. You just heard as I set that up that I just can't believe this thing is still going on since 2004 and they've never opened the doors. What is this going to cost us in a time when our budget is so tight we can't afford to fix the bridges?
Well, Bill, this American Dream Mall is turning into a nightmare for New Jersey taxpayers. As you mentioned, it's been going on for over 10 years. The first developer went bankrupt. The second developer ran out of financing. And now the third developer, 555 Group, they're a very sophisticated operator. They run the Mall of America. They own the Mall of America, mm-hmm. the West Edmonton Mall, two of the most successful malls in North America. So they knew exactly what they were in for when they purchased this property.
Yeah.
Amazingly, they're going to ask the voters of the, or the people of New Jersey to pony up $1 billion for them to complete the construction of this private mall. And this is actually a proposal. They're pitching it to the New Jersey Economic Development Authority, the New Jersey Sports and Exposition Authority. Get a load of this. So they're going to float $1 billion of bonds. Mm-hmm. And you know who's going to pay back the money? Not 555, who was handed $1 billion. As sales taxes are collected for decades into the future, that sales tax revenue that's collected at the American Dream Mall project, that's going to go to pay back the bondholders.
Wow.
That is not going to go to Trenton to fund government programs. It's $1 billion plus when you factor in the interest that's going to go back. So I have no
idea. Who's underwriting the bonds? I mean, who's the big person behind the curtain that's going to make all this money?
Well, 555 is looking for any sucker it can get to underwrite the bonds. So right now they're focusing on the New Jersey Sports and Exposition Authority for $1 billion. Previously, they wanted East Rutherford, the town where the mall is located, to float $675 million of bonds. And they have all this fancy financial language about risk, this, that, and the other thing. Oh, don't worry about it. The bottom line is 555 is getting $1 billion from the taxpayers of New Jersey, and that money, this future tax revenue that's collected, sales tax, other taxes, property taxes, guess what? It's not going to go to the government to fund government services. It's going to go back to those bondholders, and 555 is essentially getting $1 billion of free money.
And what's the incentive? I mean, what's the other side of this? You know, you're going to have some opposition, I'm sure. My guess is, this is not going to come as a big shock. I'm going to bet that Steve Sweeney thinks this is just a fine idea.
Well,
because of the construction jobs.
Well, of course, you know, nobody's standing up for the taxpayers here because all politicians who want to run, they need to get political contributions. So, look, you're paying off all the big boys. You're paying off Wall Street. My understanding is Goldman Sachs is involved. Everybody running for office wants billionaire friends who just got largesse from the taxpayers. And also on the Democrat side, there's some hypocrisy because they want all their union guys working there.
Right.
On this extremely expensive construction project. Once the government's involved in financing, Bill, everybody on the job is being paid prevailing wage, union wages, union benefits. The construction costs go up 30 to 40%. So on both sides of the coin, whether they're top Republicans, top Democrats, they're in on the deal. But the taxpayers are going to be footing the bill.
And just to just put this in perspective, so the revenue that is going to be collected as a sales tax for this new project at the Meadowlands, instead of going into the coffers, instead of going into the general fund, instead of helping offset some of our $85 billion in state debt, offset some of the future pension liabilities atop $100 billion, instead of going into the Transportation Trust Fund, etc., it's going to go back to pay the bondholders. So that means the debt is secure for the investor, and they make all the profits.
Well, absolutely. So anytime you hear any politician in Trenton complain about not having enough funding for charity care or education or our colleges, why are they standing here silently as $1 billion is being given to this very successful mall operator? And, Bill, it gets even more shocking when you consider that the same company, 555, is building the same exact type of project in Florida. Instead of being called the American Dream Meadowlands, is called the American Dream Miami. And guess what? They're not getting $1 billion for construction. So
right. You
got two states, the exact same project going on by the exact same company. Only in New Jersey do the politicians give away $1 billion.
How do we stop it, Mike?
Well, I'm on your show today.
Good.
You need to let the people of New Jersey know, because what they try to do is they bring out the financial charts and they say, oh, it's rather sophisticated, you don't understand, and this is going to improve the economy and lead to all these jobs. Malls are shutting down all over the place. We just saw Sports Authority is shutting down all their stores. But this is going to be another revel.
Yeah, I know.
We're going to invest billions of dollars in this, all these pie-in-the-sky projections, and at the end of the day, we're just taking care of the billionaire class here, and we're paying off a bunch of union guys that aren't going to say boo as they work on this project. So being sold out, Bill.
All right. You know what, Mike? I appreciate your stance on this. I am going to keep talking about it. Please keep me posted if you make any progress in the legislature on this. We got to put a stop to this. It doesn't make any sense. It's going to be a bad deal for us, as so many bad deals that have come before this. But I'm with you on this issue 100%. Keep me posted as you get more support to stand in opposition to this boondoggle. Appreciate your time, Senator.
Thank you, Bill.
All right, thanks. I'm Senator Mike Doherty, a good guy. He's standing. Where are the rest of the courageous politicians? Come on, get a backbone, guys. You got to stand up for the rest of us.